Located at a hill about a kilometer on the Uganda-Rwanda border, the school currently has an enrollment of less than 130 students, with a fear that the number may reduce in the coming academic terms due to the appalling state. The school has only 13 teachers running it. A single classroom block, which was constructed by the parents using bricks and mud about 15 years ago, also is in a very sorry state. The rest of the classes operate in temporary structures built using timber, which is rotting away. The classrooms also lack doors and enough benches for the learners. The floors are full of mud and stagnant water that fills up the structures, especially in the rainy season.
They have four classrooms, of which classrooms are in a poor state. When it comes to rain, to the season of rain like this one, we stop the teaching because the roofs start leaking, and as well as the staff room.
The staff accommodation crisis has forced eight teachers, men and women, to share a two-roomed old house.
You can see here is the teacher's quarters. It accommodates eight, it has only three rooms, but accommodates eight teachers. So two teachers sleep together, and then something that is very bad, even the female teachers sleep here with the cooks. So we don't have the teachers areas of residence.
Computer lessons are taught theoretically due to absence of a computer lab and computers. Most students do not excel in computer exams because of the way the subject is handled.
We don't have a computer lab. We teach ICT here from senior to senior four, but we don't have computers. We use a theoretic computer.
According to Godfrey Nyakahuma, the Kawale Resident District Commissioner, the 180 million shilling staff accommodation structure that had been contracted by Quid Build Contractors Engineering Limited in 2018 was abandoned before the completion. Nyakahuma says the contractor abandoned works without constructing a kitchen and lavatories. Both learners and teachers share the toilets.
The building that the government released money for the construction of staff houses, find that the contractor did not finish the work by missing out very major components of the staff houses, of those two staff houses, like the bathroom, the toilet, and which made actually teachers to delay occupying that house. And as you saw, even when they occupied that house due to really great need, you must have seen the bathrooms. They tried the makeshift kind of bathroom they put there, the toilet, and so on.
The state of the school has been attributed to poor funding. However, the school leadership say they wrote the education ministry with a proposal of 1.8 billion to first lift the school, but they are yet to have a response.
We wrote to the Ministry of Finance requesting for assistance for funding to construct additional infrastructure in that school. And most especially, we requested money for construction of a classrooms, administration block, staff houses, and multi-purpose hall, and science laboratory.
The poor learning conditions, coupled up with unhygienic environment, are also blamed for the worryingly low completion rate at the school, as most pupils fail to withstand the conditions. Report by Job Namanya in Kavale.